While an array is a convenient way to store a lot of data, it requires you to specify the size in advance. Sometimes, we don't know how many items we want to store. In this case, an ArrayList can be an excellent choice. Basically, an ArrayList acts like an array, except it grows automatically when it gets full. It allows you to efficiently access anything stored in it using a get method, to efficiently change the items stored at any location using a set method, and to add items with an add method. The size method returns how many items are currently in the ArrayList. The method readIntegers in the class ArrayListDemo shows how to create an ArrayList which will contain integers. ArrayList is a generic class, which means you can specify what kinds of things will be stored in it between the less than and greater than symbols. ArrayList can't store basic types, only classes, but each basic type has a corresponding class. For int, that is the class integer. You'll note integer is capitalized because it's the name of a class. Java automatically converts between int and integer as required. As with all objects, we must call a constructor to create one. Then, while there are still more ints to be read from the scanner, we call the add method on result, our ArrayList object, to add them. At the end, we return result. The method reverse demonstrates how to use get and set. The method loops through the first half of the array, getting one item from the first half and its corresponding item from the second half and swapping them. We set I to 0, then move the 0th entry to temp. Move the right side to 0, and then move temp to the right side. Then I becomes 1. We move the first entry to temp, move the right side to 1, and move temp to the right side. Then I becomes 2. We move the second entry to temp, move the right side to 2, and move temp to the right side. Now the loop is over, and the entries are all reversed. The methods print and alternate print show two different ways of printing all of the elements in the ArrayList. Print uses a regular for loop that counts from 0 to size minus 1, then does a get on the ith element of the ArrayList. Alternate print, however, uses a special kind of Java for loop called an iterator. Here, integer value colon list means there will be one iteration for each item in the ArrayList, and value will, in turn, be the 0th, 1st, 2nd, through size minus first numbered item in the ArrayList. Both of the loops do exactly the same thing.